Welcome! Christine E. Schulze here, aka the Elvish author, and we've got something super exciting going on today because I am finally, for the first time, going to be watching and reacting to and giving my thoughts on the movie Moana. But first, before we jump into all of that, here's a nice word from today's sponsor. Heh, psych! Today's sponsor is me! So, as some of you guys know from being on my channel, I am an author of young adult fantasy. I also have a few kids' books that focus on special needs, since that's what I do in my day job, is help people with autism and other disabilities. And I am here to present, for today, my brand new young adult fantasy book, Serenade of Kings. I actually don't have a copy right now because my boyfriend Isaac is borrowing my only copy until more come in. I do have a shipment coming. So I'll go ahead and put a picture of the cover up here on the screen for you guys. And before I say more, you know, I'm just going to play the book trailer and let that speak for itself.
King Morrigan, a powerful mental magician, desires to possess musical magic at any cost. Galia, an aspiring music mage serving in Morrigan's castle, dares to hone her rare song spell gift in secret. Crispin, a young fire mage, plays a dangerous balancing game of striving to ascend in his uncle's court while protecting Galia from Morrigan's cruel whims. Galia has only been safe from the Wicked King as long as her gift remained hidden, but, try as she might, she can't conceal that gift forever. What's more, Morrigan isn't the only one who takes notice. His brother, Alistair Ragnar, known as the Snake by those who fall prey to his charms, has his eye on the prize too. As the castle's secrets start to unravel and expose a deadly spell, a murder plot, a crafty sorcerer, and a certain prism, can Crispin protect Galia, especially from his own fiery ambitions? And, as war breaks out to rival the conflict waged inside her heart, will Galia be forced to sacrifice her love for the good of the realm?
It is the second book in the Galeon Quartet, which again is a young adult fantasy series. The first book, Prelude of Fire, people have compared to Lord of the Rings, Harry Potter. I like to compare it to The Legend of Zelda because it's a little bit more adventure and quest based. This second book definitely has elements of adventure in it, but also a lot of court intrigue, a little bit of political intrigue. So you've also got a little bit of a young adult version of Game of Thrones vibe to it as well. But yeah, a lot of magic, a lot of magic that's musically based, especially in book two and moving forward in the series. Can you read Serenade of Kings before reading Prelude of Fire? You can. I think that the series is best read in order, but the great thing about the series is that if you were to pick up any book in it and read it without reading the other ones first, you could also still enjoy and understand what's going on. So if you're super intrigued by Serenade of Kings and you're like, I don't want to read Prelude of Fire first, I'm not mad if that's what you want to do. Links will be down below in the description for Amazon and Barnes & Noble if you're interested in picking up a copy of my book. Right now, it's only available in paperback because it's a brand new book. Eventually, there will be an ebook version as well. All of my other books are available in paperback and ebook, and links to that are also down below in the description along with my social media links in case you guys want to check out more of what I have going on in the world. But enough of that, let's talk about Moana. So a lot of you guys are probably like, Christine, like, how have you never seen Moana? You know, especially since, if you know a thing or two about me, I do really enjoy Disney movies. I love a lot of Disney movies. So I'm gonna be honest and tell you exactly why I have never seen Moana. At the time that Moana first came out, I was in love with one of my friends and it was an unrequited love. And something about the character of Maui just really reminded me of this friend. So I couldn't watch the movie for years because I just had kind of like that, you know, that uncomfortable trauma response to the idea of watching Moana, even though I know that it's going to be a beautiful movie. I knew I would really enjoy it, but I just had to wait until that time to where I was ready. now, you know, you guys know, well, some of you guys know, if you've seen him on the channel, I'm with Isaac, and it's kind of cute because he is a preschool teacher, and some of his kids have compared him to Maui, so now it's like, oh, that's a nice new association, and I don't think I'm going to be upset or depressed anymore watching this movie and seeing Maui. So I'm finally at a point where, like, mentally and emotionally, I'm able to watch this movie. I've looked forward to it. Like I said, I know it's going to be a beautiful film. And I know I'm really going to enjoy it. My friend Amy, this is one of her favorite movies, so she's looking forward to, like, how I kind of react to it. You know, Adam, I've had him on the channel a couple times. He's looking forward to it. Isaac, my boyfriend, is also looking forward to it. He's also really excited to watch the movie again with me, like, once I am done doing it for the channel. So I am excited to jump into it. I'm such a queen at avoiding spoilers to anything that I'm really interested in. Moana's been out for years. There are obviously simple things I know, like the character Moana, the character Maui. I know that they exist. I know that Maui is some kind of god or demigod. I've obviously heard a couple of the songs. I mean, everybody's heard the You're Welcome song. Everybody's heard Moana's song that she sings. In fact, if I get in the mood, you know, I don't really know a lot of the lyrics, but I know the melodies, so I might sing a little bit. You guys know I like to sing. So that might happen. There's definitely going to be some other movies that we watch here on the channel that are movies that I have seen before, but that I either want to do commentary on just for the heck of it, you know, to share my thoughts, or that Isaac has never seen before. And I'm definitely bound to sing during those movies as well. It's gonna happen, guys, okay? But yeah, I don't think we need to say anything else. I think we just need to jump right into it. So strap on your elf ears, pop in your elf eyes, and let's get ready to watch and listen to Disney's Moana. Oh yeah, real quick, that one other thing I was supposed to say to you guys is, so getting back into movies, my original plan was to do a movie every week. And I don't want to commit to that right off the bat because, you know, a movie can take several hours to edit. I don't want to overcommit to something and then not be able to give it to you guys. So what I'm going to commit to is doing a movie every other week. Now, if I have a span of time where I'm able to do one every week because I have that time and I have that motivation and I don't have anything else going on, then I will. So you guys might end up seeing more movies here, you know, in certain patches of time more than every other week. But the commitment I'm making to you guys is every other week. That is the minimum commitment that you can expect from me with movies. And that'll also help me out too, you know, give me some leeway. Like, for example, I have a vacation coming up at the end of the month. I don't have to worry so much about trying to squeeze a movie in. I'm very much quality over quantity. If I can have both, I love to. But if not, definitely picking quality. So that's what you can expect. A movie every other week. I'm sure there will be weeks where you guys get lucky and I do feel like doing one every week for a little while. But that's what you can expect. So I think we're finally ready now. Let's get to the movie. Oh, guys, I want to say that I am excited, but also a little bit nervous because this movie is such a big deal for so many people. And it's been such a long time coming. Oh, there's already music. I'm gonna be quiet. I love that we're already starting this way with the music. I'm already gonna cry. I get emotional over beautiful things, guys, and over beautiful beginning. The music, everything. I'll probably cry less than usual than I would in a film because I'll be talking to you guys, but still. Gonna get emotional. Already. And nothing has come on the screen yet.
There was only ocean.
Alright, we got a story starting out.
It could create life itself.
Beautiful animation.
Shine. Some began to seek Tefiti's art. They believed if they
That's
could
cool.
possess
how she turned into the
great
island.
Power of creation. He was
this Maui?
Warrior.
Maui, you causing some trouble? That is okay. Oh.
Was Maui.
Already causing havoc. Are you our villain, Maui? I don't think you're supposed to be, but what do I know? That's cool. I love the shape-shifting, though. Oh, look at his hair! Ooh, very cool. Very cool animation.
Earth and fire to the sea.
Good job, Maui. Good job.
Continue to spread.
They're so cute.
Chasing away by the bloodthirsty jaws of inescapable death.
That is very dramatic. Yeah, I love it. I love how she's so fascinated and all the other kids are terrified. Yeah!
One day, the heart. There are no monsters.
I'm gonna terrify those kids again.
The
But Moana's just fascinated.
Beyond our reach, but storms and rough seas.
Already that young, already wanting to sail out. Oh no, he's so wee. Lost her seashell to go help the turtle. He's so cute and tiny. That is so precious. This is me, guys, but like, it's definitely me. Hey! He's so cute. I guess I do want to see baby sea turtles in real life. I know that they're like a very protected species, but I would love to be able to see that. Aww, I brought it back to her. The water looks gorgeous, guys. Animation's already on point, as I knew it would be. I respect your dedication trying to carry all of these. That is so gorgeous. Oh, there's the sea turtle. It's a big sea turtle. That is so cool. This music's lovely. I love how like the ocean's alive right now. Okay. That's the heart, right? She just had a whole little adventure there, guys. And we're only like 10 minutes in. Get your treasure.
Oh, there you
are. I want to go back.
I know.
So
but you
fresh,
don't
so
go
cute.
Out there.
She's like, no, I was just talking to the ocean and everything. It's not dangerous.
Let's go back to the village.
She's making all kinds of friends.
You are the...
I love seeing a beautiful family. Cool, and now I get to see more of the village, more of the culture.
And Moana, there's so much to
do. Oh, no.
And there you are.
She's like, I don't know if that's my fate, though. Oh, the pig! I love this message of how the island does have everything they need.
Find happiness right where you are.
But there can also be a danger in not being willing to step outside yourself and learn about, you know, outside worlds, outside cultures.
I'd like to dance with me, think I'm crazy, or say
I like grandma a lot, guys.
Stubbornness and pride. Mind what he says, but remember, you may hear a voice inside.
You can become too insulated. You can become so scared of the outside world that you miss out on something.
Moana,
so
voice inside is who you are.
When you will stand on this peak and place a stone on this mountain.
We're gonna see that later, guys, aren't we? It's gonna be important.
My father did, and his father, and every chief that has
That's
ever
cool.
been.
I'm assuming that a lot of this is actual culture from real life. If you guys could tell me like what culture like these people are representing, that would be really cool. I would love to live on an island, honestly, to have everything I need, the food, the natural food and everything.
I'll have my people to guide me.
You will lead the way, but that doesn't mean that your fate won't take you elsewhere in order to help them. That's beautiful. I do love that message of finding happiness where you are, but again, you can't be too insulated. Sometimes you need to step outside yourself to learn.
Shifted the post.
Oh.
That's good pork.
Thinking outside the box. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, this is me. I don't want to... I can't have needles with my allergy shots. I don't want a tattoo either, guys, even though I think they look really cool.
To lack the basic intelligence required
for pretty much everything.
Yes. Maybe just cook him.
Oh no. Sometimes also, I love that he's cooking cabbages.
Beneath the surface.
And that makes me think of the cabbage guy from Avatar.
We've tried the whole lagoon. They're just gone.
Everything's dying because you're supposed to restore that heart. Shouldn't have lost it when you were 2 years old.
Every time I think you're past this.
This is in her. So you can't get past who you are. I mean, I don't blame him. He's just scared. He doesn't want anybody to get hurt, you know? Especially his daughter.
He's hard on you because he doesn't get me. Because he was you. Drawn to the ocean. Down by the shore.
Backstory.
Your dad couldn't save him.
So again, not blaming the parents at all. Totally understand. Dad's having that really strong trauma response from losing his friend, and he doesn't want to lose his family as well.
I've been staring at the edge of the water long as I can remember. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try.
Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes.
If the wind in my sail on the sea
is behind me, no telling how far I'll go.
I know
everybody on this island
seems so
happy on this island.
Everything is by design.
I know everybody on this island
has
a role on this island.
So maybe I can roll with mine.
With pride, I can make us strong.
I'll be satisfied
if I play along.
But the voice inside
sings a different song. What is wrong with me?
Well, come find
me
and let me
know. What's beyond that line? Will I cross that line?
The line with the sky is the sea.
It calls me. No one knows.
Find my girl. I like that she's caught between wanting to place that stone and be the chief like she's supposed to be, but then following this destiny of hers, and I'm guessing both are going to converge, and that her going and finding her destiny on the water is going to ultimately help her people and be exactly what they need. Gotta be willing to think outside the box sometimes, or in this case, outside the island. Sailed, girl. It might be even a calm day, but you do not know what to do with those waves. That would be terrifying. Oh, okay. That was nerve-wracking. First attempt. Realistic. Didn't go off. Lord, don't let your father see this.
Blame it on the pig.
Grandma.
Yeah, you totally went out to rescue the pig. She knows.
Are you gonna tell Dad?
I'm his mom. I don't have to tell him anything.
She's so precious. She low-key reminds me of Iroh from Avatar.
I'm to put my stone on the mountain.
I think you can put your stone on the mountain after you go into the water to help your people.
Said that's what you wanted.
She's so cool communicating with all the creatures. Look at the stingrays. Yeah, use that reverse psychology.
I'm going to come back as one of these.
That would be dope.
You've been told all our people's stories, but one.
Yeah, that's always the case.
What?
I want you guys to know that I'm already completely charmed by this story.
The answer.
And these characters.
To the question you keep asking yourself.
Why does she want to go out there?
Who are you meant to be?
Wow, what are all these ships, I wonder? Are these ships they used to take out, or are these ships that they came in by? Oh, that's Maui on the sail, okay. Oh, it's got a turtle on it, like the turtle she rescued when she was a little kid. And it's so beautiful visually, guys. Even that makes me emotional because it's just so beautiful to look at. Oh, that's a big one. I hear that. I hear the drumming back. All right, we're getting some history here, guys. Please do tell me again, like, what culture we're representing here and what language we're singing. I know I've heard of it, but I don't remember which culture that we're in here. I saw how far on a boat was. Oh, look at the stars. That is awesome. This is very much like the song at the beginning, where they were saying, we know who we are, we belong to this island. And these guys are saying, we know who we are, we belong to the sea, and they're not afraid to explore.
We were voyagers!
Yeah.
When he stole the heart, the island, darkness fell.
And the island started to die?
Awoke.
Monsters lurked and boats stopped, and a darkness has continued to spread.
Yeah, I think it's here.
Chasing away our
on our island too now.
Driven him across the great ocean.
To restore the heart.
To restore the heart.
Grandma, how do you have this?
Fiti. I was there that day.
Of course
the
you was.
The ocean chose you.
Oh, I love this, Grandma. And I love how it like talks and responds to her. That is so cool.
Ancestors believe Maui lies there.
A constellation for Maui.
Follow it.
Stop the darkness. Save our
island. Oh,
no. I mean, covered a boat.
This isn't going to go well.
We can voyage again.
This is probably bad timing.
We need to help our people.
This is
this
the way.
This is how we help our people.
You guys step outside.
Dad?
Grandma. Where's Grandma?
Chief! It's your mother!
I know, I was worried about that.
What can be done?
Is she gonna die, or can fixing the island also...
Maui, you grab him by the ear and restore the heart of the feet.
That's so cool.
There is no way you could go that I won't be with you.
I need to know, guys, if she's gonna die.
Go.
And that's her dying wish. Well, she probably thinks that is her grandmother's dying wish. Or if we're gonna be able to save her by saving everything else. But this is the motivation, this is the character motivation. We gotta go. With the stars, absolutely gorgeous. Oh no. Oh. Oh, it's like an ocean. Ocean push. Oh, it's the stingray, like her grandmother. Yeah, girl. Guys, I wanted you to know that if I wasn't, like, talking and reacting, I would actually be crying through this entire movie. I can feel it, so. Oh. Oh, do we have a stowaway? Oh, no. Is that the... That has to be the rooster, right? Like, because I'm just thinking of, like, that noise. Or he keeps knocking his head on the rug. Yeah!
Hey, hey!
Hey, hey! Hey, 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 hey! What a companion. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, oh, no, hey, hey, no, 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 no.
Hey, hey!
Hey, hey, I'm sure you have a purpose, but I'm really waiting to see what it is. Oh, no, no! So, can you tie him up somewhere? Very good, he's not smart enough to get out of this. The crash course in learning how to sail. The stars are gorgeous. I love, like, the animation in this. Oh, water's gonna keep you awake. I want you guys to know that I love the water, but I can't swim. And so it's just a good thing that this isn't my fate. Now that would be terrifying whether you can swim or not. Especially knowing her father's story. Ooh, that is a cool shot, guys. That was a really dope shot with the lightning. Pardon me, too much crying. We'll have to blow my nose at some point. Why, bro? Maybe the storm brought her where she needed to go. Maybe Maui's on this island.
All day! So...
I mean, true. Just leave him. He's not going anywhere there. I was about to say, I wonder if you are on Maui's island. The ocean knows what it's doing.
Maui?
Thank you. I love that the water is a character in this, guys.
The gods have given me a
man! They've given you a tiny woman that you are afraid of.
Hero of men. I interrupted from the top.
You're okay.
Yeah, okay, we're not a little bit full of ourselves, are we?
You use a bird to write with.
Oh.
It's called tweeting.
Also, we found a purpose for the rooster.
You are not my hero. And
yet.
I'm not here.
1,000 years trying to get the heart as a gift for you mortals, so you can have the power to create life itself. Yeah, so what I believe you were trying to say...
Maybe he was trying to do a good thing?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
But... No. I didn't...
Sometimes you can be misguided and try to do a good thing.
You don't even know how you feel. It's adorable. Well, it's nice to see that humans never change. Erin had a demigod.
What can I say except you're welcome? Hey, it's okay. You're welcome. Just an ordinary guy.
So what can I
say except you're welcome? Pulled from the sea.
There's no need to pray,
it's okay. You're welcome.
I guess it's just my way of being me.
I love the animation in the background. That's so cute.
Hey, it's okay.
I love the art style.
And thank you.
Oh, no. No. We can share the boat. All right. So Maui's a little full of himself. He has done a lot of things as a demigod. So fair.
Beating with some kid.
Is this your conscience?
You have yours, and I'm not Maui.
You have a tattoo conscience?
Okay. Talk to the back. Boat snack.
Oh, no. I mean, again, that would be something he's good for, but I love that he has, like, the little tattoo conscience. Like, I love that so much. He doesn't understand. You're going to regret this decision. He does not understand. Well done. Like, super parkour. Ow.
I could watch that all day.
All right. Either the ocean's going to turn him around or his tattoo conscience is going to turn him around. Or the ocean might just take us there. That could also work.
And Moana of Motuno.
Say it, girl.
All right. Get over it. We got to move.
I am Moana.
And we're going to get through this speech eventually. Ocean's gonna hit that back like a tennis ball. See? You've actually met your match. The ocean is, you've met your match.
I'm not afraid.
Maybe he is, because of what happened. Oh, well, his tattoo's very...
Stay out of it, or you're sleeping in my armpit.
I think his tattoo is like what he really thinks and feels, guys.
The second I took it, I got blasted out of the sky and I lost my hook. Get it away from me.
This away?
Hey, I'm a demigod, okay? Stop that.
You're not scary.
You want to get smote?
We're not worried about you, Smitey.
You're welcome.
Oh no. What do we have? Is it pirates?
Murdering little pirates.
Yeah, pirates! Oh, they're so cute! I want to be friends with them. Oh my goodness, I love them. Guys, I want to be friends with them. They're so cute. Why?
You can't sail?
No. Nope. The ocean just kind of brought us here.
Self-taught?
I love them. I really do love them. Keep the chicken in there. He will get killed otherwise. I know I'm supposed to be worried about this, but I'm mostly very intrigued about these pirates. They're very efficient. Okay, oh, chicken. Yeah, eat it! Eat it! That might actually be helpful. Or not, because of course the chicken's gonna get kidnapped.
We have to get him back!
Listen to your conscience! I like the Maui's, that when we're introduced to him...
escaping...
That we're... That he's being forced to do things without his magic.
Hey,
oh my goodness. Which I think could also be a good lesson for him, you know?
They're coconuts.
But they're so cute! Are they coconuts or like their armor, right? Like that's so adorable. Oh gross. Get us out of here, Maui. Mad skills with no magic. Those were like the most entertaining villains, and I love them.
Ever defeat a lava monster?
No. Have you?
I'm wondering if the monster's really gonna be a monster though. Like they threw things out of balance by taking the heart. Maybe things aren't going to be as they appear? You're just like the island people, letting the fear control you, bud.
You'd be a hero.
Nah, there you go.
The guy who cursed the world.
That is how the humans see you.
You're no one's hero.
Oh, even the ocean is agreeing. Listen to your conscience.
Wait,
deal.
He's so much bigger. Look at he's so big. Like his hands, like her hands, so tiny compared to his.
If anyone has
bottom, I think they're both adorable. What an adorable team, guys.
Teach me to sail.
I'm about to say, give her a sailing lesson.
First, I'm not a princess. I'm the daughter of the chief.
Same difference.
No.
I mean,
if you wear a dress and you have an animal sidekick, you're a princess.
everybody's against you, bro.
Not the sheep.
The ocean, the tattoo conscience.
Nope.
Yeah, learning how to read the stars.
Not giving the sky a high five.
Would be really cool to do. Is this where we started? Oh, no. Okay. At first, is it? Oh, I wonder if this is a dream, perhaps? Yeah, this has to be like a nightmare. I hope it's a nightmare. Okay.
We're here.
Ooh, that's formidable. I would love to real life island hop and just experience all the different rock formations, all the different types of plants and animals. Like, that would be really cool, honestly.
It's collectible.
How does he actually ever eat anything?
There?
Also, this would be really fun to play in a video game. Makes me think of Wind Waker a little bit, but imagine if, like, Wind Waker had really, like, extensive islands like this.
Realm of Monsters?
Look at those rocks. These are so cool.
Are
I want to see those in real life, guys.
That's what I'm talking about. Give me some.
He's not about it.
A good one.
He's not on your team. He's on her team.
Then it's not funny.
Mari's adorable. It's kind of nice to see a demigod with some lack of self-confidence, who has some fears, who has to
daughter of the chief,
rely not entirely on magic.
In the village. If the ocean's so smart, why didn't it just take the heart back to Tefiti itself? Or bring me my hook? The ocean straight up kooky.
I think because you wouldn't learn anything that way. Yeah, I'm pretty sure nobody would learn anything if the ocean just did all the work for you guys, so.
Ocean chose you for a reason.
If you start singing, I'm gonna.
You sang a song.
Because it only appears after a human sacrifice.
Oh.
Kidding.
Yeah, there's a face. It's like the mouth opening. Very cool. Again, this would be super fun in a video game.
Don't worry.
Also in real life.
Farther down than it looks.
But also, I would suffice for a video game. So, they say don't worry. It's a lot farther down than it looks. Did we just go through the ocean?
And he sticks
to ground beneath the ocean. That's such a cool concept. I love when things do that. I actually have something like that in the book that I'm working on.
Okay, let's get my hook.
Where beneath the ocean, there's actually like a layer like this where it's ground. So that's really cool. Thankfully, in my book, there's not a realm of monsters under the ocean. Yeah, that's so cool how the ceiling is the ocean, but, you know, you don't have to worry about the ocean crashing down. It also makes you think a little bit of Wind Waker again, like... That would be terrifying in real life, to see coming at you. Not gonna lie. It reminds me of, like, a dragon's hoard with, like, all the gold and treasure.
Fish hook.
Yeah.
Sparkle.
I low-key really like that shell as a hat and kind of want to wear it.
He loves bragging about how great he is.
Oh, like you.
He must get along swell.
Oh, not since I ripped off his leg.
This is like a dragon with a hoard of gold hiding inside his treasure.
What have we here?
Oh, my.
It's a shiny.
Oh, he's wearing it on his shell. That's cool.
Just pick an eye, babe. I can't concentrate on what I'm saying.
We mortals have heard of the tale of the crab.
Keep working it.
It became a legend.
Keep working it.
It has become so crab.
Crabulous. I like this word a lot, guys.
Are you just trying to get me to talk about myself?
Yes.
Because if you are, I will gladly do so.
Yeah.
In song form.
Yes. Please sing for us. So we can get your hook.
Well, Tumut can be happy as a crab.
I like that he has jewels on his teeth, even, guys. Baby. Get it! Do we have magic again? Oh, no. Which leg did he cut off? Are we finally in agreement? Oh, no. I was like, this is gonna go wrong. He hasn't used this thing in a while. He either forgot or something's wrong with it. Did you break it? I'm really trying to see if he's still missing a leg.
My sons who abandoned you,
chasing the love of these humans who made you feel one day.
So maybe Maui has a bit more of a tragic story as well. And maybe he was helping the humans to feel love, like if he got abandoned type of thing.
You can't run from me.
That's not the heart, is it?
Oh, you can.
Did she paint something with that stuff?
He can have it. I've got a better one.
Yep, good girl. Good job. I really want to see Maui regain all of his confidence and feel like a hero again. I feel like there's more depth to his story that we haven't seen yet, guys. No.
We're alone!
Listen.
Awkward.
I'm trying to be sincere for once, and it feels like you're distracted.
No.
Well,
no.
You know.
Really? The point is, for a little girl, child, thing, whatever.
You're gonna say thank
who
you.
You had no business being down there. You did me a solid. Bupkis.
See, I really want to see him regain his confidence. I wanted more of his story. It's. Oh no. Oh. I'm just out of practice, bro. Oh, that's unfortunate. Cursed.
Hey, it's okay, it's okay. Oh, we're dead soon.
All right, break time's over.
Yeah, can we learn more about that?
How do you get your tattoos?
That's a good question. It's a good lead in there.
That's a man's discovery of Nanya.
What's Nanya?
Nanya business.
What's it for?
You need to stop doing that.
You need to open up your emotions. You got stuff you gotta work through.
Back off.
It's good for you.
I said back off.
Is it why your hook's not working?
You know she's gonna come back.
It's just me and you. And I want to help. But I can't. If you don't let me.
Gotta let people in. It'd be good for you, sir.
I wasn't born a demigod. I had human parents.
Really?
They took one look and decided they did not want me. They threw me into the sea.
Oh my.
Like I was nothing. Back to the humans I went. I gave them islands, fire, coconuts.
He gave him all these things. He just wanted to be
anything
loved.
Anything they could ever want.
You took the heart for them. You did everything for them. So they'd love you.
It was never enough.
Oh, I really love him so much, guys.
But the gods aren't the ones who make you Maui.
No, you are.
You are.
I love seeing just a big, strong guy in this character, but seeing him have these insecurities and having, you know, and having all these things to learn from and having this big heart, I love that. Well, now I want him to regain his confidence, but also I hope that he finds love. And I think that he will at least find that in his friendship with Moana, you know? There you go. Yeah. Oh no! Is Hey Hey gonna have any purpose, or is he just there for comic relief? Because, you know, the princess always has to have an animal companion. Love the bonding, love the friendship you guys are forming. Both of them are not sure of the role they're meant to play. But they're learning together. They're learning, you know, self-worth and confidence and all these good things together. And you love to see it. They're both learning a lot from each other, both about sailing and things like that, but also internally as well.
That is literally the nicest thing you've ever said to me. Probably should have saved it for Tiffy.
I did.
Hey, we're here.
Moana of Motunui, I believe you have officially delivered Maui across the Great Sea.
You're very sweet. And I like that this isn't, you know, I mean, I love romantic stories, but I also like that we're having a story that has a guy and girl character that are just bonding as friends and not having a romantic relationship, just seeing a nice, different, wholesome, almost brotherly, sisterly type of relationship, you know? Again, totally cool with romance, but it's nice to see something different for a change as well. Oh no. I still can't get over, this has nothing to do with anything that's happening on screen. I still can't get over that his parents didn't want him and tossed him into the ocean. What a feeling of being unwanted, guys. My goodness.
And I just really adore him as a character. But also learning all about his background and his desire to help people and just find that love. Especially because I've experienced, like, feeling unwanted before. Like, not to that degree where my parents tried to toss me in the ocean, but it's just such a relatable thing. I like how relatable of a character, like, Maui is. And again, it's good to see that in a man's role, having all these emotions, okay? Not being afraid to go through them and process them, not being afraid to want to show love to people and have love from others. Oh, no.
I told you to turn back.
Oh, no.
I thought we could make it.
We're gonna have a fight. We're gonna have a friend fight.
Art.
Without my hook, I am
that's
nothing.
That's not true.
Without my hook, I am nothing.
I mean, I completely understand why he feels that way, but it's not true, darling.
The ocean chose me!
It chose wrong.
I feel like that's kind of like a parallel there, too, because what if he feels like the ocean chose wrong for him as well, you know? With just being so unwanted by his family. Oh, it's the grandmother stingray.
If you are ready to go home, I will.
I love that she's being really graceful and giving her that choice, too, and not, like, pushing her, like, you have to do this. I love Grandma's character so much, guys.
Moana, listen. Do you know who you are?
I am the daughter of the village chief.
This refrain and this moment with the grandmother are so beautiful. I love seeing the spirit of them as well. And that's why I thought too, the ocean dropped the stone because there is nobody else. She is the one meant to do this. That blue light is the same as has been lighting up the ocean. And so now I'm kind of wondering, more than the ocean leading her, if it's also been like the spirits of, you know, her ancestors. But that was a beautiful scene between her and her grandmother, like, and her grandmother letting her figure it out for her own and like not forcing her, but having her figure out who she is. Taking everything that she's learned on this big journey.
None of which you understand, because you are a chicken.
I think that the chicken is kind of like making fun of the fact that they always have to have an animal sidekick because he's been so useless this whole time.
No!
Hey! Do something useful for once! Work. That is Hi Hi's one contribution to this entire film. Yeah, there he is. I knew he would come back at some point. Yay! Proud tattoo, conscience.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. I love the animation for it. I keep forgetting his name, but this big fire guy. I love his animation. He looks so cool. I mean, all the animation in this has been fire. No pun intended.
Get the heart to the spiral!
You're on the island, guys. You two work together! Do it! Woo! Oh man. You get him? Was it worth it? Oh, that's shaped like a woman.
Tafiti. It's gone.
Oh, the spiral is there. That is Tafiti. Maybe without her heart, that's what she turned into.
Let her come to me.
She figured it out. That is another gorgeous shot. Gorgeous.
Who you are.
Oh, there's so much in here about knowing who you are and not letting those outside things define you.
All the death falling away. Let's see it. Oh, this is also reminding me of the Sprite story in Fantasia 2000, which is one of my favorite things. That, you know, life rising from death. Oh, that's exactly what it makes me think of, but we're going to talk about that later, guys.
Hook? No Hook.
You're still a hero, and you're still Maui.
Hey, I mean, how you been?
Aww.
It'd be rude to refuse a gift from a goddess.
He may not define you, but it's still yours. You can be excited about it.
Thank you. Your kind gesture is deeply appreciated.
I love this visual where she's just covered by the flowers. Hey, decked out boat. Very good. Oh, she gets to return to where she belongs. That is so cool. That was so cool, guys. I told you guys, beauty makes me emotional. Oh, she gets a story on the tattoos. Now, Tattoo Moana and Tattoo Maui, they can hang out. They can be friends. Oh, life coming back. We love to see it. I love this image of her coming in, you know, as one of the Voyagers, just like their people were way back in the day.
It suits you.
Yeah, I like that he said that. Because he said that before about her being, you know, acting as a chief and doing things on the island. It's like him understanding her now. Bro, thank you for still keeping him in check. Oh, River, get the boats back out. Oh, see, now she can be ready? Oh, that's so cool. New tradition. It was always stones, but her thing's the ocean, and so she adds the shell instead. Very symbolic, very good. And then I'll come talk to you. Hey, psych! Today's sponsor is me. So, as some of you guys know from being on my channel, I am an author of young adult fantasy. I also have a few kids' books that focus on special needs, since that's what I do in my day job, is help people with autism and other disabilities. And I am here to present for today my brand new young adult fantasy book, Serenade of Kings. I actually don't have a copy right now because my boyfriend Isaac is borrowing my only copy until more come in. I do have a shipment coming. So I'll go ahead and put a picture of the cover up here on the screen for you guys. And before I say more, you know, I'm just going to play the book trailer and let that speak for itself. Okay, so I'm going to like talk in... hope to not, I don't know, I don't think I'll get too emotional on you guys, but that was a very beautiful movie, which I knew it would be. I've always known that it's something that I would love and enjoy once I was emotionally ready to watch it. Amy had told me the only thing she said going in is that it's a very pure story, and it was a very pure story. I appreciate a good story with a good villain. I like to create good villains myself in my books, you know, and everything, but it's also nice to have a story that, you know, doesn't have a villain sometimes. Because there really wasn't. It was just more about misunderstandings, you know. Maui, I love his character so much. Him just being cast off and that feeling of feeling unwanted, which I think is going to be something that a lot of viewers, unfortunately, can relate to. But hopefully, you know, it's also nice to be able to have a character to connect to and understand when you've had those things also in your own past. So while, you know, it sucks that people have had those feelings, it's also nice that they create a character that people can connect with on that level. just the fact that him being cast into the ocean unwanted by his parents, I mean, that is just awful, but also symbolic. You know, there are people who feel and who are unwanted by their families, but then they go on to find their own family. They go on to build family. You know, I think that he ends up having a connection with Moana and gaining love from her and love and acceptance from her. So that's a really beautiful message. There was a big theme throughout of knowing who you are and not letting outside things and experiences that you can't control define who you are. So with Maui, it was him being cast aside by his parents, and then he gets the hook as a gift from the gods. But he feels, you know, he has that feeling of like insecurity and kind of worthlessness without his hook, because he wasn't wanted by his parents. Why would anybody want him without his hook? Why would anybody want him if he can't be this hero? But then he gets to learn that that's not what defines him, that he is still Maui. He is still who he is. He is still a value and worth with without his hook. You know, it's the same thing with Okay, I'm going to stop messing up the name of the goddess so that I don't botch that and be disrespectful to name it. But the goddess, you know, turns into that fire monster because that's how she feels without her heart. It's more like her embodying all that sadness and rage and grief. But then even then at the end, Moana reminding her, like, hey, like, yes, your heart was stolen from you, but this is not the only thing that defines you. You are still this goddess. You are still this protector, this life giver. So that's just a really beautiful message that sometimes outside things happen. Sometimes we have this pain and this grief from all these outside things that we can't control. People that hurt us, circumstances, situations that hurt us, but they don't define who we are. We can still find who we are inside. And of course, there was this journey of Moana finding who she was inside. And, you know, I think the difference was is that she had someone to guide her. She had her grandmother. I loved the grandmother's character. I loved the relationship between her and her grandmother. I think it is obvious to me now that, yes, her grandmother did pass away, but she did have the spirit of her come as, you know, the stingray. And I loved that scene with her and Moana on the ocean. And I said this while watching, but one thing I really liked about the relationship is that her grandmother always encouraged her, you know, to find who she was, but she never pushed her. She never pushed her, you know, like her father was kind of pushing her, like, you are the chief. This is what you're going to be. You're going to be the next chief. And again, understandable, not mad at him, completely understand his perspective. You know, loss and grief were big in this one. And so he lost his friend. And so, of course, he wants his daughter to be the next chief. He doesn't want her to go sailing, exploring, completely understand his perspective. So not down on the dad at all. But he was really trying to push her into that role, whereas the grandmother knew that the ocean was calling her, but at the same time didn't really try to push or force her. She let it be her choice and let her discover who she was and make those decisions for herself, which I think is really a good message as well. It's good to encourage people and kind of guide them toward their path, but without pushing and forcing them, because a lot of times people won't follow something if you force them into it, and also a lot of times they won't necessarily learn as much. Same thing with Maui. He kind of had to learn some of his self-worth before he got his powers back without his powers, you know, which I thought was really good. And also, I think a really good message to young men. I liked Maui's character. He was strong. He was physically strong, you know. He was mentally strong. He was a very capable guy. But at the same time, he had a tenderness. He had a softness. He had a sensitivity. He wasn't afraid. I mean, he was afraid to show emotions, but he did open up and he did learn to do that. And we did see that he had some insecurities and that he had to overcome those and build confidence. And I think that's a good, you know, a good message for young men, is that it's okay to open up, to confront your emotions, to learn to heal from them, and to learn that your worth isn't just bound up in your strength or, you know, any other things that society might say, like a guy has to be this, a guy has to be that. You know, finding his actual self-worth was not having to do with any of those things. Great message there. Definitely loved it. Loved all the characters. Loved the every bit of the animation. I said that the goddess at the end, you know, when she turns from the fire monster back into the goddess, and she's just covered in green and the flowers, just really, really reminded me, like I said, of the Sprite story in Fantasia 2000. If you guys have seen that, I love Fantasia 2000, but really, literally the Sprite story. I could just watch that over and over again. That really inspired me as a kid to create some of the fairies and some of my books. And I love stories of birth, death, and renewal. And I guess you could see that a little bit in here as well. You know, at the beginning, you have the voyagers going off and discovering life and all these islands. And then when the heart is stolen, you have kind of the death of that. And the death puts them into fear. But then you have that renewal of life at the end when the goddess rediscovers who she is. Everybody else rediscovers who they are. That's another thing, too. Like, Moana, you know, Moana learns who she is. Maui learns who he is at heart. The goddess remembers who she is at heart. But also, Moana helps remember, her entire people remember who they are at heart as well, because you see them going off and voyaging at the end. So it's a really beautiful movie where everybody has a journey of self-discovery. So, yeah, I just realized that, but that's really cool too. But yeah, animation was beautiful. Loved every bit of that. Loved the music. I'm going to say this to all of you guys, but also a little bit to Adam. So I showed Adam Encanto recently, because that's a movie that is just absolutely gorgeous and has some gorgeous messages in it. And he said that he, you know, thinks that that Encanto might even be a little bit better than Moana. I don't know if he still has that opinion. You know, it's been a couple weeks. I have to say it's actually really hard for me. So in this moment, I'm just like, oh no, maybe Moana's my favorite. But honestly, Moana and Encanto are both really beautiful, top-notch films with beautiful messages, beautiful animation. So I don't really know if I could say yet, like, which one would be my top. Like, I might have to, like, rewatch this one. I definitely would love to rewatch this one. I definitely was emotional throughout the film. I wasn't crying probably quite as much as I would if I, you know, wasn't filming and, like, focusing on, like, making sure I'm saying, like, what's in my head and everything. But definitely was still emotional. So you can tell it's a good film when I'm filming and I'm still able to get emotional, you know, and be that immersed in it. So, yeah, beautiful film. Definitely, I mean, even though I've only seen it once, I'm going to call this one of my favorite Disney movies, because I already feel that, you know. Also, just all the nature, the beautiful animation, the stars, the water, the messages, but also, you know, about life and renewal and creation, and all of those things are just really things that, like, I connect with a lot as well. So just, like, the focus on nature in here also really brings it up for me. In case you guys are curious, some of my favorites are definitely Tangled. I might put this up here, actually, with Tangled, which is saying a lot. Tangled's one of my favorites. Encanto's one of my new favorites. You know, there are certain classics like The Lion King and Beauty and the Beast that are definitely my favorites. And just so you guys know, I will be obviously doing a lot of movies on here like this that I have never seen before, but I am going to do a few that I have seen, just to give my thoughts on them as well. So you might get to see some of my favorites with me and hear my commentary and my personal thoughts on them. I'm trying to think. Is there anything else I want to say? I really love Pua, the pig. I really want this little pig. And I think he's adorable. And I know that there is an island, I believe it's the Bahamas, where you can actually go swim in the ocean with pigs. And maybe there's other places like that too. I don't know. But loved the pig, even though he was not a major part of this story. There's just so many little things I could say. You know, Maui's tattoos, the stories they tell, you know, him adding the tattoo of Moana at the end and her becoming an important part of his story. There's so many other little things I feel like you could go into. Feel free to talk about those down below in the comments. If there's anything I haven't talked about that you really want to discuss, any little detail I may not have noticed that you want to point out, since I've only seen it once. You guys have probably noticed things if you've watched it more than one time. And I'm just going to stop talking, otherwise we'll talk about the movie all day. So on that note, thank you so much for watching. Okay, so I'm going to like talk and hope to not, I don't know, I don't think I'll get too emotional on you guys, but that was a very beautiful movie, which I knew it would be. I've always known that it's something that I would love and enjoy once I was emotionally ready to watch it. Amy had told me the only thing she said going in is that it's a very pure story, and it was a very pure story. I appreciate a good story with a good villain. I like to create good villains myself in my books, you know, and everything, but it's also nice to have a story that, you know, doesn't have a villain sometimes, because there really wasn't. It was just more about misunderstandings, you know. Maui, I love his character so much. Him just being cast off and that feeling unwanted, which I think is going to be something that a lot of viewers unfortunately can relate to, but hopefully, you know, it's also nice to be able to have a character to connect to and understand when you've had those things also in your own past. So while, you know, it sucks that people have had those feelings, it's also nice that they create a character that people can connect with on that level. Just the fact that him being cast into the ocean unwanted by his parents, I mean, that is just awful, but also symbolic. You know, there are people who feel and who are unwanted by their families. But then they go on to find their own family. They go on to build family. You know, I think that he ends up having a connection with Moana and gaining love from her and love and acceptance from her. So that's a really beautiful message. There was a big theme throughout of knowing who you are and not letting outside things and experiences that you can't control define who you are. So with Maui, it was him being cast aside by his parents, and then he gets the hook as a gift from the gods. But he feels, you know, he has that feeling of like insecurity and kind of worthlessness without his hook, because he wasn't wanted by his parents. Why would anybody want him without his hook? Why would anybody want him if he can't be this hero? But then he gets to learn that that's not what defines him, that he is still Maui. He is still who he is. He is still a value and worth with without his hook. You know, it's the same thing with Okay, I'm going to stop messing up the name of the goddess so that I don't botch that and be disrespectful to name it. But the goddess, you know, turns into that fire monster because that's how she feels without her heart. It's more like her embodying all that sadness and rage and grief. But then even then at the end, Moana reminding her, like, hey, like, yes, your heart was stolen from you, but this is not the only thing that defines you. You are still this goddess. You are still this protector, this life giver. So that's just a really beautiful message that sometimes outside things happen. Sometimes we have this pain and this grief from all these outside things that we can't control. People that hurt us, circumstances, situations that hurt us, but they don't define who we are. We can still find who we are inside. And of course, there was this journey of Moana finding who she was inside. And, you know, I think the difference was is that she had someone to guide her. She had her grandmother. I loved the grandmother's character. I loved the relationship between her and her grandmother. I think it is obvious to me now that, yes, her grandmother did pass away, but she did have the spirit of her come as, you know, the stingray. And I loved that scene with her and Moana on the ocean. And I said this while watching, but one thing I really liked about the relationship is that her grandmother always encouraged her, you know, to find who she was, but she never pushed her. She never pushed her, you know, like her father was kind of pushing her, like, you are the chief. This is what you're going to be. You're going to be the next chief. And again, understandable, not mad at him. Completely understand his perspective. You know, loss and grief were big in this one. And so he lost his friend. And so, of course, he wants his daughter to be the next chief. He doesn't want her to go sailing, exploring. Completely understand his perspective. So not down on the dad at all. But he was really trying to push her into that role. Whereas the grandmother knew that the ocean was calling her, but at the same time didn't really try to push or force her. She let it be her choice and let her discover who she was and make those decisions for herself, which I think is really a good message as well. It's good to encourage people and kind of guide them toward their path, but without pushing and forcing them, because a lot of times people won't follow something if you force them into it. And also a lot of times they won't necessarily learn as much. Same thing with Maui. He kind of had to learn some of his self-worth before he got his powers back without his powers, you know, which I thought was really good. And also, I think a really good message to young men. I liked Maui's character. He was strong. He was physically strong, you know. He was mentally strong. He was a very capable guy. But at the same time, he had a tenderness. He had a softness. He had a sensitivity. He wasn't afraid. I mean, he was afraid to show emotions, but he did open up and he did learn to do that. And we did see that he had some insecurities and that he had to overcome those and build confidence. And I think that's a good, you know, a good message for young men is that it's okay to open up, to confront your emotions, to learn to heal from them, and to learn that your worth isn't just bound up in your strength or, you know, any other things that society might say, like a guy has to be this, a guy has to be that. You know, finding his actual self-worth was not having to do with any of those things. Great message there. Definitely loved it. Loved all the characters. Loved the every bit of the animation. I said that the goddess at the end, you know, when she turns from the fire monster back into the goddess, and she's just covered in green and the flowers. Just really, really reminded me, like I said, of the Sprite story in Fantasia 2000. If you guys have seen that. I love Fantasia 2000, but really, literally the Sprite story. I could just watch that over and over again. That really inspired me as a kid to create some of the fairies in some of my books. And I love stories of birth, death, and renewal. And I guess you could see that a little bit in here as well. You know, at the beginning you have the voyagers going off and discovering life and all these islands. And then when the heart is stolen, you have kind of the death of that, and the death puts them into fear. But then you have that renewal of life at the end when the goddess rediscovers who she is, everybody else rediscovers who they are. That's another thing too, like Moana, you know, Moana learns who she is, Maui learns who he is at heart, The goddess remembers who she is at heart. But also, Moana helps remember, her entire people remember who they are at heart as well, because you see them going off and voyaging at the end. So it's a really beautiful movie where everybody has a journey of self-discovery. So, yeah, I just realized that, but that's really cool too. But yeah, animation was beautiful. Loved every bit of that. Loved the music. I'm going to say this to all of you guys, but also a little bit to Adam. So I showed Adam Encanto recently, because that's a movie that is just absolutely gorgeous and has some gorgeous messages in it. And he said that he, you know, thinks that this, that Encanto might even be a little bit better than Moana. I don't know if he still has that opinion. You know, it's been a couple weeks. I have to say it's actually really hard for me. So in this moment, I'm just like, oh no, maybe Moana's my favorite. But honestly, Moana and Encanto are both really beautiful, top-notch films with beautiful messages, beautiful animation. So I don't really know if I could say yet, like, which one would be my top. Like, I might have to, like, rewatch this one. I definitely would love to rewatch this one. I definitely was emotional throughout the film. I wasn't crying probably quite as much as I would if I, you know, wasn't filming and, like, focusing on, like, making sure I'm saying, like, what's in my head and everything. But definitely was still emotional. So you can tell it's a good film when I'm filming and I'm still able to get emotional, you know, and be that immersed in it. So, yeah, beautiful film. Definitely, I mean, even though I've only seen it once, I'm going to call this one of my favorite Disney movies because I already feel that, you know. Also, just all the nature, the beautiful animation, the stars, the water, the messages, but also, you know, about life and renewal and creation and all of those things are just really things that, like, I connect with a lot as well. So just, like, the focus on nature in here also really brings it up for me. In case you guys are curious, some of my favorites are definitely Tangled. I might put this up here, actually, with Tangled, which is saying a lot. Tangled's one of my favorites. Encanto's one of my new favorites. You know, there are certain classics like The Lion King and Beauty and the Beast that are definitely my favorites. And just so you guys know, I will be obviously doing a lot of movies on here like this that I have never seen before. But I am going to do a few that I have seen just to give my thoughts on them as well. So you might get to see some of my favorites with me and hear my commentary and my personal thoughts on them. I'm trying to think. Is there anything else I want to say? I really love Pua, the pig. I really want this little pig. And I think he's adorable. And I know that there is an island, I believe it's the Bahamas, where you can actually go swim in the ocean with pigs. And maybe there's other places like that too. I don't know. But loved the pig, even though he was not a major part of this story. There's just so many little things I could say. You know, Maui's tattoos, the stories they tell, you know, him adding the tattoo of Moana at the end and her becoming an important part of his story. There's so many other little things I feel like you could go into. Feel free to talk about those down below in the comments. If there's anything I haven't talked about that you really want to discuss, any little detail I may not have noticed that you want to point out, since I've only seen it once. You guys have probably noticed things if you've watched it more than one time. And I'm just going to stop talking. Otherwise, we'll talk about the movie all day. So on that note, thank you so much for watching. If you are not subscribed here and you want to know when the next movies as well as shows are coming out, I am doing two shows at a time on this channel. Feel free to subscribe. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please like it so that other people like yourselves can find and enjoy it as well. And we can all talk about Moana together. And if you like, leave a comment. Totally not necessary, totally not required, but I do enjoy talking with you guys here on the channel. And since this is a movie, not a show, and I've seen it, there's no worry about spoilers. So you can talk whatever you want to about Moana. On that note, thank you guys so much for being here. Happy watching, and I will hope to see you in my next video. Bye.